Hello everyone. Welcome to this video on how to load a report from Bold Reports report server in a JavaScript application. Before getting into the procedure, let's take a look at the Bold Reports report server. The report server is a report management studio provided by SyncFusion, which allows the user to create, manage, and share reports securely and easily. Our report server provides a built-in REST API service that helps you embed the server's reports. In this video, I will show you the steps to create a JavaScript application and the steps to load an already published ssrs report from our report server into the JavaScript application. First, let's see how to generate the personal access token from the report server. To generate the personal access token, first, you need to log into the Bold Reports report server. You will see the list of reports that are published to the report server. To generate the personal access token, I click the user emoji icon in the left navigation bar. Then I click the user profile. We will be redirected to the My Profile page. I click the personal access token in the top panel. In the personal access token page, I click the Generate Token button. A confirmation dialog is displayed to generate the personal access token. Click the Yes button. We will see the bearer token is displayed in the authentication token text box. Click the Click to Copy button to copy the generated access token. Next, let's see how to create the HTML file. Create a new folder and name it. I named mine JS Report Server. Open the folder in Visual Studio Code. I am using Visual Studio Code for editing purposes. You can use any editor to get started. Create a new HTML file, name it index.html, and type the code. Let's see how to reference the scripts and stylesheets in the HTML file. Reference the necessary scripts and stylesheets in the head tag. And format the document. I have provided the documentation link in the video description for your convenience. The purpose of each script and stylesheet is explained in the following table. Bold.reports.all.min.css includes the CSS properties for the JavaScript reporting component. The jQuery 1.10.2 script is used to render the SyncFusion JavaScript reporting widgets. ej2base.min.js, ej2data.min.js, ej2pdfexport.min.js, and ej2svgbasemin.js are used to render the gauge item. ej2lineargauge.min.js renders the linear gauge report item. ej2circulargauge.min.js renders the circular gauge report item. ej2maps.min.js is used to render the map report item. ej.chart.min.js renders the chart report item. bold.reports.common.min.js, bold.reports.widgets.min.js, and bold.reportviewer.min.js are required to render the Bold Reports report viewer. Now, let's see how to add the report viewer widget in the JavaScript application. Add the div element inside the body tag. Inside the div element, I assign the ID and style attributes. The ID attribute specifies the unique name for the HTML element. For this demo, I assign the value viewer to the ID attribute. The style attribute is used to add the inline style for the div element. For this demo, I have assigned the width and height of the div element. Add the report viewer widget inside the div element. To render the report, set the report service URL, report server URL, service authorization token, and report path properties for the report viewer widget. The report service URL specifies the web API service URL. The service URL contains the server name, service name, and REST API name. The format of the report service URL is http://reportserver-name/reporting/report-service/api/viewer. In this demo, I have hosted the report server on my local machine. So I have specified the report server name as localhost along with the port number in which I am hosting it. You can use your own report server name. Reporting/report-service represents the service name of the report server. API/viewer represents the web API name of the report server. The report server URL specifies the server name and site information. The format of the report server URL is http://reportserver-name/reporting/api/site/site name. In this demo, I have set the report server name as localhost along with the port number in which it is hosted. You can use your own report server name. Site/site1 represents the site from which we are going to load the report in the report viewer control. Since I have kept my report in site1, I specified site/site1. You can specify your own site's name. The service authorization token specifies the personal authorization token, which is already copied from the report server. The report path specifies the path in which the RDL report file is published in the report server. Here I am using the sales order detail RDL report from the server location. This report is published in the sample reports category. Save the file. Now, everything is ready to preview the embedded report. To preview the report, open the index.html file in a browser. You can see the sales order detail report is loaded in the bold report viewer. Let's briefly cover the procedure for loading a report from the cloud report server. The steps that need to be followed are the same, but the report service URL and the report server URL will differ based on your cloud server configuration. I have shared our cloud reporting sample report service URL and report server URL in the presentation. Since the service for cloud reporting is hosted separately, reporting/report-service is not set in the report service URL. And since multi-tenancy is not supported in the cloud reporting server, the site information is not required in the report server URL. You also need to generate the service authorization token from the cloud report server and add it in the application. And the path of the report, we want to render in the report viewer. I have provided the documentation link in the video's description for your convenience. In this video, we learned how to embed a report server report in a JavaScript application using the report viewer control. Stay tuned to this channel for our upcoming videos on bold reports. Don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.